Good morning, students. This is part 3 of our lecture, motion. Yesterday, we discussed about distance and displacement. Distance, you came to know it is the length of the actual path traveled by the body, and displacement is the shortest distance between initial and final position of the object. Okay, both can be measured. Okay, so that's why distance and displacement both are physical quantities. So physical quantity, how we can define this? Any quantity which can be measured. Koi bhi quantity jisko hum measure kar sakte hain, maap sakte hain. That quantity is known as physical quantity. Okay. Now talking about some examples of physical quantities. Let us consider the length of a line segment. Now, this is the line segment AB. And if we measure the length of this line segment, this is let it be 2 meter. Okay, so 2 meter is the length of the line segment, so it can be measured. So length is a physical quantity. Now talking about time during the day. So time, we can measure what is the time, and at any instant we can measure the time. Weight, vegetable, like weight of vegetables or sugar. So weight of vegetables, or we can say mass of vegetable, how much vegetables we take, so we can be measure that. Okay, as well as sugar. Okay, at any shop if you will go and ask for sugar, you will say ki I want 1 kg of sugar or 2 kg of sugar. Okay, so that can be measured. That's why weight or mass can be measured, and it is a physical quantity. So length, mass and time, all are physical quantities. Now consider about the types of physical quantities. Here are mainly two types of physical quantity. One is vector quantity, second one is scalar quantity. Vector quantities are those physical quantities which has both magnitude as well as a fixed direction. If a body moves, okay, if a body moves, it will cover some distance. Okay, that is the size of the object, how much it covers distance, and in which direction the body moves. So both, if we'll consider as a whole, so those, that quantity is vector quantity. We can take an example of displacement. Displacement is a vector quantity. Force also, if we apply some force on any object, okay, it must have some direction as well as the magnitude. Velocity, speed of the body in a particular direction. You know about speed, and today also we are going to discuss about speed. Now talking about scalar quantity. Scalar quantities are those quantities which have both magnitude, jiske paas kya hota hai, sirf magnitude, uska sirf size hota hai, but do not have any fixed direction. Koi fixed direction mein wo nahi batate hame. Okay. Like distance is what? It is the length of the path. So length again is a scalar quantity. So distance is a scalar quantity because it has only magnitude. Magnitude here, if we talk about here 2 meter, so 2 is what? Magnitude, the size of the object. Okay, or we can say size of any quantity. Time, like I say, it is 10:30 a.m. morning. Okay, so 10:30 is only the magnitude, but there is no direction ki it is 10:30 in south direction or north direction. Okay, now talking about speed. Speed is what? Distance traveled. Distance again is a scalar quantity, and in a particular interval of time again scalar quantity. So division of two scalar quantities again a scalar quantity. Let us take an example with the help of which we can easily understand the magnitude and direction as well as distance and displacement. Magnitude, again we came to know, okay, this is the size of an object or quantity. Direction, if a body or a vector moves from one point to another, that is the direction. Like in this direction or in this direction, like this only. Okay, I draw the direction pattern here. That is east, west, north, south. Every time you are going to solve any numerical like this, you will draw the direction pattern on like this only. So this is the origin, or I consider it as my home. If I move towards east up to 5 meter, then take a left turn and moves up to 2 meter in north direction. Again, I take a left turn and moves up to 5 meter in west direction. So now my final position is here. This is my final position and this is my initial position. So total distance covered by me is the length of the path, that is 5 plus 2 plus 5 5 plus 5 10 or 2 12. So total distance travel is 12 meter. And what is the displacement? I'll draw a straight line path here, and between initial and final position my displacement will be 2 meter. And in which direction? Towards north. So this is displacement. Now I think you all are understand and clear with distance and displacement, magnitude, direction. Now talking about motion, we discussed different types of motion. They are linear, straight, curvilinear, or we can say circular, rotatory, vibratory, oscillatory motion. Let us discuss about two more types of motion. One is uniform motion, second one is non-uniform motion. Uniform motion, uni means unique and form means roop, we can say. Okay, ek rupi matlab jo throughout its motion वो क्या हो, एक जैसी बॉडी मूव करे एक जैसे तरीके से. सो अगर बॉडी मूव कर रही है तो इट कवर सम डिस्टेंस एंड इट हैज सम इट हैज टेकन सम टाइम आल्सो. सो इफ अ बॉडी कवर्स इक्वल डिस्टेंसेस इन इक्वल इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम, देन द मोशन ऑफ द बॉडी इज सेड टू बी यूनिफॉर्म मोशन. ओके, if it covers equal distances in equal interval of time, then body is in uniform motion. And if it covers equal distance or equal time in equal time or unequal interval time or distance, like let me clear this, if a body covers equal distances in unequal interval of time, that is also non-uniform motion. Or if it takes equal time but distances are unequal, then it also a non-uniform motion. Or we can take the both, like if a body covers unequal distances in unequal interval of time, that is non-uniform motion. So this is the example, like time in seconds, and it takes 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And the distance covered by the body is 0. When the time was 0, distance was also 0. Now the time is 2, distance covered 10 meter. If the time is 4 second, distance covered 20 meter. So what is the distance gap here? 10 meter. Okay, then 10, then 10, then 10, and time is 2 2 2. Time interval is 2 meter and distance covered, and the equal distance is there, that is 10 meter. So body covers equal distances in equal interval of time. But if we talk about non-uniform motion, body covers unequal distance, like 0, 10, then 15, then 28, then 15, then 10, then 6, then 30. So time taken is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I have taken equal interval of time, but the distance covered by the body is unequal. So that's why it is a non-uniform motion. Most of the motion are non-uniform motion. Okay, there are very less motion where which are uniform, which are uniform. Okay, like on a empty road, if a car moves, so we can take ki body ne ya us car ne bahut hi kam samay ke liye uniform pattern follow kiya hoga. Otherwise, the body kis mein move karti hai, mostly non-uniform motion mein move karti hai. Okay, if it consider some examples of this non-uniform motion, here are, if a body freely fall, okay, under the force of gravity, then it is a non-uniform motion. A train starting from one station and stopping at another station, so in between, that is non-uniform motion. Okay, now talking about rate of motion, motion ki kya dar hai, kis dar se body move kar rahi hai, and that rate of motion is known as speed. That rate of motion is known as speed. Okay, so speed, how can we define this speed? Speed is the distance traveled by the body per unit time. Per unit time mein body ne kitna distance travel kiya hai. Okay, let us this consider this. Body is at position A, and if it moves, it is in motion, and it reached up to point B. So it covered a distance of 50 meter, and how much time is taken is 5 seconds. स्पीड इज व्हाट? डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड पर यूनिट टाइम. सो व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ टू कैलकुलेट स्पीड? इज द डिस्टेंस डिवाइड टाइम. स्पीड कैन बी डिनोटेड बाय वी, स्मॉल वी. डिस्टेंस कैन बी डिनोटेड बाय एस एंड टाइम डिनोटेड बाय टी. सम स्टूडेंट्स गेट कंफ्यूज विद दिस एस एंड वी. सो डिस्टेंस एस की वहां साउंड ज्यादा आ रही है तो उसको हम एस से डिनोट करेंगे. स्पीड, स्पीड अगेन डिनोटेड बाय वी ओनली. ओके, इन द कमिंग लेक्चर्स देयर वेलोसिटी विल बी देयर, दैट इज ऑल्सो डिनोटेड बाय वी. डिस्प्लेसमेंट कैन ऑल्सो बी डिनोटेड बाय एस. बट इफ यू टॉक अबाउट डिस्प्लेसमेंट देन इट इज डिनोटेड बाय लाइक दिस ओनली, एरो मार्क, बिकॉज इट इज अ वेक्टर प्रेजेंटेशन. सो डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, सो इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड लाइक दिस ओनली. ओके, सो हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द स्पीड ऑफ दिस बॉडी कवर्ड फ्रॉम ए टू बी? सो डिस्टेंस डिवाइड बाय टाइम, इट इज 50/5. तो टोटल द स्पीड ऑफ द बॉडी ड्यूरिंग इट्स मोशन वॉज 10 meter per second. नाउ वट टाइप ऑफ यूनिट स्पीड इज? स्पीड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट एस आई यूनिट, सिस्टम इंटरनेशनल यूनिट, यू रेड अबाउट दिस इन सिक्स क्लास. ओके, सी जी एस सिस्टम वॉज देयर, एम के सिस्टम वॉज देयर, एस आई सिस्टम, एम के एस एंड एस आई सिस्टम बोथ आर सेम. सो हेयर स्पीड, यूनिट ऑफ स्पीड इज मीटर पर सेकेंड. वाई मीटर पर सेकेंड? डिस्टेंस इज मेजर्ड इन मीटर इन एम के एस और एस आई सिस्टम ऑफ यूनिट, एंड टाइम इन ऑल द सिस्टम ऑफ यूनिट मेजर्ड इन सेकेंड. सो मीटर पर सेकेंड इज द यूनिट, एस आई यूनिट. सो एवरी यूनिट कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड लाइक दिस ओनली. सो डिस्टेंस इज मेजर्ड इन मीटर, टाइम इज मेजर्ड इन सेकेंड. सो मीटर पर सेकेंड इज द एस आई यूनिट ऑफ स्पीड. And what type quantity of quantity speed is? Scalar quantity, because it does not tell us about any direction. It tells us, us only about distance traveled per unit time. Okay, beta. So today we discuss about physical quantities. Okay, different types of physical quantities, vector and scalar, and we differentiate between distance and displacement on the basis of vector and scalar quantities. Distance is a scalar quantity, displacement is a vector quantity. Okay, motion, uniform, non-uniform motion. Uniform motion, ek roopi motion jo hoti hai body ki, body covers equal distances in equal interval of time. Non-uniform motion, bodies cover unequal distances in unequal interval of time. Okay, we consider some examples also. And finally, we talk about speed, that is a distance traveled per unit time. Okay, beta. So in today's assignment, we'll go through with this all questions. Okay, about speed, uniform, non-uniform motion, and some numericals are also there. Okay, thank you, beta.